We found out that Hamas chief Yahya Sinwar was killed by Israeli forces. The Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said that his death marked the quote-unquote beginning of the end of the conflict and promised to slow down the war if Hamas fighters put down their guns and allow Israel to take the hostages back. And, of course, Sinwar was the mastermind behind the October 7 attacks. And finally, they've got probably the biggest piece of the puzzle, Claire. As to whether or not this actually ends anything, I don't know. I mean, it makes the job of fighting for Hamas a lot more difficult than it was because they don't have the top dog there anymore. But they're not going to put down their guns.
No, the job's not done. And that's, you know, the Israeli Prime Minister saying that. It could be the start of it being done, but it's not done. And there will be many more members of Hamas now ready and able to take their leader's position. I mean, they may be in some amount of disarray now, but at the end of the day, this is not, I don't think, about Gaza anymore either. This is about eliminating and dismantling terror in the Middle East. You know, and that is why the world and the West should get behind Israel as they're battling on multiple fronts there to maintain some type of democracy there. And, you know, none of us like looking at the horrific nature of innocent civilians and Palestinians being killed, none of us. But Hamas, they've got to realise, has inflicted just as much pain and suffering on the Palestinian people as they have, you know, terrorising Israelis. And, you know, it's Hamas who are in the tunnels hiding when things get a bit tough and the civilians are out on the ground, and it's Hamas who run away and leave the country, you know, to
yet
hide
not
away.
A single Greens MP would celebrate or pass on any kind of condemnation of Hamas or goodwill that their leader had been taken out. I think Netanyahu had an opportunity here to say, right, we said we would fight till we win Hamas, till we've beaten Hamas. We've killed the top of the guy, top of the tree. We've killed the guy who organised the October 7 attacks. Give us back our hostages.
Correct.
And we'll come to the table.
Hamas have said the hostages are not going to be released. They've already taken a stand.
No, I know, but that's right. But if Netanyahu had been clear, instead of saying, oh, we're going to slow down, or instead of saying this is not the end, it's just sort of the beginning of the end or the end of the beginning or whatever, again, I think he's showing that he himself, I think Israel needs to do a much better job of showing that it is not the aggressor, that it is not interested in perpetuating this war for its own sake and setting down clear moral markers. And frankly, you know, I'm certainly no, you know, I'm 1,000% pro-Israel, but Netanyahu is not doing himself any favours by not being clearer about that. And the truth is he can't be clear about
it. No, we've got to stop telling Israel what to do. Israel knows what to do. They know what they've got to do.
Israel is more than Benjamin Netanyahu.
Yeah, but they know there's only one thing they have to do. They have to win. It is fairly clear from what's happening. They know how to do it, and they're doing it very well. We're not in that difficult situation. We should pull our heads in. If we've got any advice, give it to Hamas, give it to Hezbollah, give it to Iran, and we should not be telling Israel what to do. They're good at what they're doing, and they won't stop till they win, which is great.
There are plenty of Israelis who are not on board with Benjamin.
Oh, of course, and domestically that will continue to play out. We've got to get to a break, but I've got to tell you, in his final moments, there was a drone coming in that was monitoring. He threw a piece of wood at it. I mean, the bloke staged a terror attack. The biggest slaughter of Jews since the Holocaust, and his final moments involved throwing a piece of wood at a drone. I think he got what he deserved.